I'm going to make a circle, a diameter, and a perpendicular to the perpendicular bisector to the diameter using a bow compass. First thing I'm going to do is mark the center point, put the pivot on the center point. I actually find it easier to turn the paper instead of the compass. There we go. That's my circle. I'm going to then pull out the straight edge. With the straight edge, I'm going to put the pencil right on the center point, bring the straight edge up to the center point. There it is. And then this one, I'm going to name the end points of this diameter, well, D and M. Okay. Now to make the perpendicular bisector of this diameter, I'm going to open the compass a little further than it currently is. So, fine. There it is. It's open now a further than one radius. I'm going to put the pivot of the compass on one of the end points of the diameter, and I'm going to make a swing, an arc. There it is. Okay. I'm going to put the pivot on the other end point of the diameter, and I'm going to make another arc. Fine. There it is. And then I'm going to use my straight edge again. And I'm going to, if I did it right, if I line it up with this intersection of the arcs and that intersection of the arcs, it should go right through my center point. And it does. Okay? I'm going to label this place where the perpendicular bisector intersects with the circle P, and I'm going to label this place B, and that's it. I've now constructed a circle, a diameter, and a perpendicular bisector. I could say that the line segment PM is perpendicular to the line segment D. No, that's not correct. Let's say that again. The line segment PB is perpendicular to the line segment DM. And I could say that this, I'm going to label the center point of the circle O, that line segment DO is congruent to, which means the same size and shape as, the line segment OM. And so, there it is.